In a neutral atom quantum computer, each and every quantum bit is encoded in an individual atom. Quantum bits, or qubits, are the elementary processing and storage units of any quantum computer, and in our case we use atoms to realize them. We use lasers to trap and manipulate the atoms and let them interact with each other to create entanglement. But why atoms? First, atoms are the world's most pristine qubits. They're all exactly the same. For example, a hydrogen atom on the moon is exactly the same as a hydrogen atom on Earth. Their properties are given by nature and there's no variance in how they appear. So there's no production variance. This lets us assemble large quantum registers out of exactly identical building blocks already today. And this is important since non-identical building blocks can be a source of error. Second, atoms are extremely coherent. This means that once brought into a quantum superposition, this superposition can be kept unaffected and error-free for a very long time, which is one of the most important prerequisites for quantum computing. In fact, that is why atoms are also used in the world's best clocks. An atomic clock is so precise that two such clocks started at the same time at the beginning of the universe would be off by only about a second by now. Third, atoms are extremely abundant. 1 gram of material contains on the order of 10 to the 23 atoms, such that we'll not run short when scaling up our quantum computers. And what are the challenges? Like in any quantum computing platform, controlling our system atom by atom, qubit by qubit is the biggest challenge. We have to control a large number of laser beams steered at individual atoms to manipulate their states. Together with our partners in Munich Quantum Valley, we are making great strides in manipulating more and more atoms, moving them in highly complex orchestrated ways, and connecting all the dots towards execution of basic quantum algorithms.